warm welcomes to a slice of the action. But if you're not a foodie, don't panic, because this is the culinary quiz for those people who think that winkles aren't shellfish, but are something else entirely. And playing again today, as ever, our two celebrity chef team captains. On my left, the delicious and delightful Amanda Grant.
Hello.
And on my right, the well past his sell-by date, Andrew Nutter. Playing again alongside Amanda, not one but two celebrity male guests, the wonderful Yabu Hiss, John Altman. And the fantastic Mr. Melvin Hayes with us. Meanwhile, over on Nutter's side, well, to his right, he is a lucky man because he's got the lovely Liza Goddard. And to his left, he's a lucky geezer as well because he's got the beautiful Mandy Smith. Those are the teams. Here comes the game. Now, on this show, we don't play for points or pounds or prizes. We play for fruit. And also, you don't play so much to win as to avoid losing, because the losing side will face a forfeit roulette. And one team member will have shame, disgrace and public humiliation heaped upon their head. So, with that warning in mind, let's get underway. Because before the show, we asked all our guests to fill in a food file. Confidential and maybe incriminating information about their food likes and dislikes. We asked, for example, both John and Melvin and Liza and Mandy, which dish do you always cook to impress? Now, which of these four possible answers are what John and Melvin actually said? That's what Nutter's team have got to work out. We asked them, which dish do you always cook to impress? Did they say bangers and mash, breakfast in bed, cheese souffle, or chateaubriand? What do you reckon, Nutter and Co? Start with John first.
John, I reckon...
Breakfast in bed.
Are you speaking from personal experience there?
Although I have heard he does a wicked cheese souffle.
Have you?
Yeah.
Where have you heard that from then?
He told me. But I don't know.
He told you.
I'm going to go with the girls.
Breakfast in bed for our John. And turning to Melvin, which dish would he cook to impress? The ones you got left are bangers and mash, cheese souffle, or chateaubriand.
Well, chateaubriand.
Chateaubriand.
I don't know what it
is.
I was trying to know what chateaubriand was.
I'm not going to be able to eat chateaubriand because there's so much meat in it.
Well, he's a man of craft.
So you're saying
Monday.
John would cook breakfast in bed. John, what would you actually cook to impress?
It is, in fact, the souffle.
Oh!
A little tip, can I mention a well-known chef who's written some books for me on the show? Dealey Smith. I was cooking in front of a TV camera, almost live, and there was one little detail in there for any of you cooks out there. After I'd mixed up the cheese and it was all ready to go in the dish, said, take a small silver spoon and just fold it for 60 seconds. Oh, that won't make any difference, surely. And I thought, must do it. And it rose and it was perfect. Very lucky. But all those little details, we're just going to stick with
them. We should be charging you extra for this. John Altman's cheese souffle masterclass. Which means that you must have been wrong when you said he was a cheese souffle. So what would you cook to impress, Melvin?
Bangers and mash.
Good old honest fry. So,
onion gravy. You've got to have onion gravy. Lots of onion gravy. They have to be beef.
Beef sausages.
Well, I mustn't advertise.
Fold them with a tin spoon first, or do not bother.
I want to know is how can you fold a tin food over a tin spoon over 64 times? Did you say?
Well, you gently fold.
Oh, the soup up in the spoon.
Moving swiftly along now, we ask the same question of Nutter's guests. We ask them, which dish do you always cook to impress? Here are four possible answers. Is it spaghetti bolognese, lobster, beef olives, or pheasant? Two of those are right, two are wrong. I'll remind you what they are. Spaghetti bolognese, lobster, beef, olives, or pheasant? Start with Liza first, please.
Right.
I think she's a bit of a cook. I think she'd be very good in the kitchen. Very creative.
Yes.
Would enjoy cooking.
Bottle of wine to the right hand.
Bottle of wine to the left hand. Bottle of wine.
Do you think would be the most impressive?
Pheasant. Yes, definitely. Yeah. Lots of feathers and things.
Well, there was spaghetti bolognese, beef, olive.
Beef, olive, or lobster.
I'll go for the lobster, myself.
It could be lobster, couldn't it? Lobster or pheasant.
But they're very obvious. You see, they're very obvious. What are the other nasty ones?
Spaghetti bolognese, beef olives, lobster or pheasants.
Spaghetti bolognese.
No, I'd go for Mandy.
I could be right.
Me too.
I could be wrong.
Would you go for Mandy, Melvin, as well?
Oh, yes, please.
Lisa. Yeah. Okay, but lobster. Mm.
Lobster for Lisa and for Mandy. Spaghetti bolognese, pheasant or beef olives?
Bolognese,
man.
Why is that bolognese kind of girl, do you think?
I go for beef olives, just to be different.
Well, she's a busy girl.
Young,
energetic, busy schedule, I should think, most of the time. Not a lot of time spent in the kitchen, eating quite a few restaurants, no doubt, around and about, like we all do, you know, in the glamorous world of showbiz.
No, joking apart, I think, yeah, bolognese, anyway. Spag bowl, you going over all Melvin, then? The team captain's decision?
No, I don't care, love, I'm going in a minute.
Well, OK. Lisa, they said you were lobster, you were in fact...
Pheasant.
Oh, yeah?
I said pheasant, didn't I?
Yep. You said everything, though, Melvin. You said all four.
Next time, Melvin.
And Mandy, they said you were spag bowl.
All right, yeah.
Spag bowl is right. So, the first bit of fruit on the show is given away a fine melon from Melvin's team. As we move swiftly along to play Guess the Gadget. Yes, I want the teams to fondle my kitchen cool after they put on their blindfolds and stick their mitts into an oven mitt. We're going to start with Amanda's team first. Get those blindfolds on. Fruit at stake for the person who can correctly identify my rather unusual bit of kitchen gadgetry.
How can you see what you're going to put on?
Ladies and gentlemen, it's Deputy Dog.
Oh! Right. Is that one?
That's one, yeah.
And that's the other one.
He's done it. He's way ahead there because the first gadget is...
Beef olives.
Are we ready? Here it is.
Okay.
Take a look at it.
Right, talk to us now, then.
But what...
I'm trying to feel it.
Do we do it in the...
Just give us your first impressions.
Oh, no. Okay. First impressions. It's a canister of some sort. I mean, like a... It's got four sides and a top and a...
What's it made from, do you think?
Nothing now, it's broken.
Plastic.
Plastic, okay, pass it along. Amanda, have a little feel and a fiddle. There's one little thing he hasn't been able to find that you want to fumble for, I think. It'll give you a bit of a clue.
Right.
Feel every side, lower
so there's
down.
Something, it's smaller at the top and then a bigger base. Oh, with a little handle-y thing
the
here.
Handle.
Right, now
so
what's
then obviously it might possibly go in the top.
Oh, so you put it in the top and sort of push something through and it comes out the bottom.
Like a shred or a whisker or something.
Something
like that. Mm. Bit of a ripple for that. And let's let John have a feel. Here we go. John, how could you be so nasty to your mum, eh? Poor old dog, son. Hey?
Ah, is this the reason you invited me here today? Have your...
To point the finger.
Revenge. You've got to look. I always say, Paul, you try living with her. Neurotic, gossiping, chain-smoking old... No wonder he's the way he is. I reckon it's... Can I say what...
Do you want to have a little...
We having a little conflict. It feels very sort of blenderish to me.
Yes. Mm. Shoot there with it and you blend or shred or whatever.
Is it something for putting sauce in or something? Or
Have a quick confer then, because we'll need a decision in a couple of seconds.
Are we allowed another feel?
Yeah, pass it along to... are you talking about the gadget? Yeah. Right, Melvin, yes. Pass it along to Melvin again. Amanda?
Vegetables or...
Amanda, pass it along to
him. Oh, sorry.
In front of you now, Melvin.
It's like an arm. It's like an arm.
Have you got it?
Yes, darling, yes, I think so.
Hey, Melvin, you break it, you buy it.
Oh, yeah. Where's it gone?
Paul, it's turned into a beautiful girl. She lives in London somewhere, but I can't see her.
Okay, I think we need a guest now.
It's a coffee grinder.
Which one are you going to go with, Amanda?
Not a coffee grinder, it's on the floor. Vegetables or cheese or something like that.
I'll go along with Amanda on that because she's like the professional chef here, so yeah.
Whatever she says.
Okay, vegetables. You want to be a bit more specific?
It's
a blender. No.
Grinder.
Normally when Paul says that, it's actually nothing to do with it. It's probably
okay, I think you've had long
cheese
enough.
And veg
I don't
grinder,
think
you're going
to get it. I don't think the audience actually spotted it. It is, in fact, you take your blindfold off, something called a No More Tears onion dicer. You peel your onion, stick it in there, put the lid on, and you can shred it up nicely.
But how useful.
If someone had done some grinding, we might be able to...
Yeah, onion's a vegetable, for sure.
None of you used it,
but it could have been, maybe a marrow or something, couldn't it? So no fruit for Adam, afraid.
Okay,
for that, have a line for that. Go on.
Plastic.
Put your blindfolds on, please. Lisa and Nutter and Mandy. And we have another little doohickey for you three. And here... It is. Now, I'm not altogether sure how this works, but I do know what it's meant to do. Mandy.
Hello.
It's a big moment for me, Mandy, this is. Yeah. With you in a blindfold. There we go. Give it a feel.
Is it long, round?
It's don't be so powerful.
It's long metal.
Long metal.
Metal. Sort of, oh, God.
Like a whisk?
No, it doesn't feel like a whisk at all.
Is it the same all the way along it? Or?
No.
I can give you a little bit of a help on this one, though, right? Because I think...
Is there a few bits?
It's kind of Chinese puzzle-y.
Oh.
And it comes out a little bit like... Can have one end each.
Okay.
You've got an end
goodness.
Each now,
oh,
right?
Yeah.
And no, it's not a chest expander for Melvin Hayes.
Is it bending all the way across?
Is it what you put cakes on or something? You know, to air?
Let's pass it off. Let's let Liza have a feel.
Yeah, cooling track. Cooling
track.
Like a cooling
track. Try and get hold of the end. Oh!
Where have I heard that before?
Like, so there's lots of wires, right?
Like it's very quite light, isn't it?
Is it for fruit or cakes? Is it for cakes?
Cakes, Sam. Is it for barbecuing? Is it for putting something weird on a barbecue?
No, it's not for barbecue.
Would you kind of eat on it? Would you put fish on it? Fish.
It just feels like a piece of rack in the oven, doesn't it?
It's a rack of some kind.
Oh,
that's pretty good.
Putting meat on.
So what I need to know is what it's actually for.
Putting meat on over the
when you actually
roast
it in the oven, all the excess fat comes. So when you roast duck, is that?
It's kind of it's not the oven process we're after on this one.
No. Does the audience know what it is? Must be quite unusual then. Chef, it's fun.
Take your blindfolds off, because I think Nutter got there with a bit of help from Mandy. Liza, you weren't much help at all, I'm afraid.
Sorry about that.
It is in fact an expanding wire cooling rack for just about anything from cakes to fish. So I'm going to give you a banana and generosity knows no bounds in this show. A great big melon. Well held, and now it's time for me. Well, I'm going to take a quick look at the scores first. A melon and a miserable lone, slightly shriveled lime on my left, but a banana and a melon on my right, which means just about, it's almost too close to call. Who cares? You're in the lead. As I prepare to open my glittering golden envelope, because I'm about to give our celebrity chefs a cooking task. Not too difficult, you might think, except in this round, they cannot use their hands or even point prepare the dish. They've got to just verbally bully and abuse their co-contestants to make for me guacamole. Guacamole. A kind of what? Vegetable Mexican dish. Just 3 minutes to make it. Get your aprons on, guys and gals. And your 3 minutes starts just about now.
This is very difficult.
You're having trouble with the apron, you're having trouble with the dish.
Are you all right?
Shall I do
you up?
You cook much at home,
though, John?
Not enough. I really enjoy it.
There you go.
But I never get a lot of time to do it.
You've got 3 minutes there.
Right, it's all on here.
We need some avocados, garlic.
What are we making?
Some oil.
Guacamole.
You want to undo that?
Oh, guacamole, yeah.
Yes, there's avocados. We've got a blender down there, John.
Avocados, bit of a clue.
Put your blender up.
He's chilled up.
Right,
I'm moving over to the side to see how they're getting along.
Everything's
salad
at all. Actually, we'll do a salsa from the middle, avocado salsa.
How do you do that then?
So I'll be looking at the presentation end taste.
Yeah.
Right.
So we'll blend the avocado. Do you want to start the salsa?
You're making me nervous. Keep looking at that pan while you're cutting it.
There's some chopping boards under the table.
Oh, it's under there.
Chopping
boards.
Chop
the garlic. Finished, is it?
No, we need the blender. Can you bring the blender up?
Nice bit of slicing pleaser as well.
We're making a salsa as well. The avocado salsa.
Right.
Enough now. Some garlic in there, please.
Okay, thank you. While they're cooking, you may be fancying a cup of tea or even the chance to whip up your own bit of guacamole. So, we're going to take the shortest of short breaks back after a breather with part two of a slice of the action. We'll see you the other side of this. Keep watching. No. Not too much oil. Welcome back to A Slice of the Action. Now, before the break, we set our two celebrity teams a culinary caper, a challenge. They had to prepare for me, in just about 3 minutes, a portion of guacamole. I'm afraid I've got to take my life into my taste buds now and have a little nibble, because this one, with me, Amanda, how did it go? How was it for you?
Well, let's just talk about the presentation first.
First of all, I don't want to let this slip off the plate. They have cut out of the avocado skin a lovely J for John. And an M for Melvin.
This is all Melvin.
Give Melvin a round of applause.
Isn't that interesting?
But what are those yellow bits of dog sick doing?
Cool. Okay, it's not as green as perhaps it should be. But our avocados were very underripe.
Okay, now
and
if
they did add quite a lot of oil as well.
Right, a lot of oil, too much oil?
Maybe slightly heavy.
You have a taste first.
Oh, okay.
Every confidence in
not too much.
Do you want to dip a finger in there, John?
I'd like to see what we created.
It's lovely and garlicky and lemony.
It has a sort of,
not that bad.
Je ne sais quoi.
Quite sweet.
Did you put a lot of sugar in it, Melvin?
No, I wasn't looking.
Put some sugar in. Did you notice?
The sugar is sort of... It's actually not too bad, is it? It's not as bad as I thought.
It's not as bad as I thought it was going to be.
Ah, thank you, see? But the sugar did it, the sugar.
It certainly isn't guacamole.
No.
Because it tastes more like a dessert.
Which we call it a hazy oli.
Well, yeah. So for that, I'm going to give you... For the presentation, I will give you an orange, but not much else, I'm afraid. Give a round of applause. Butter fingers. As I taste the one I'm really... Now, this
I've got two experts on my side.
First of all, let's just look now. First of all, who did the main body of it, that lovely garnished avocado?
It was Lisa. Lisa did the main part. Lovely with a little salsa.
Bit of salsa.
Mandy made the guacamole.
And who dressed the outside of the plate?
Lisa.
It looks beautiful. I think you look great. And I'm going to taste it now. Got a little taste then, Nutter?
I will.
Dip your finger in or...
Do you think they put sugar in there instead of salt?
I don't quite know what happened to it, but it is an interesting experience, and I think I'll be living with the aftertaste for some months.
That is delicious.
That is lovely.
That is what it should be like.
That's very good.
Right.
Enough.
Pass it over. That Melvin, just taste a bit of that, mate. Now that is, that's guacamole, isn't it?
You just cut my tongue in half.
Well, I'm going to give them not one, but two lemons and yet another banana. Oh, yeah. Look at the stars. Well, not bad over here. I suspect they've kept some of their ingredients from culinary capers because they've got a melon, a lemon, a lime and an orange, but I'll let them keep it because of their ingenuity. On my right, though, two nanas, two lemons, a melon, and go on, have a lime as well. In the lead, Nutter's Gang, ladies and gentlemen. And now it's time to close your eyes and unblock your lug holes, because we're going to play What's That Sound? Each team will have three kitchen sounds, and they've got to identify them to get a bit of fruit for each one. Starting with... guacamole sticking to the top of my mouth. Starting with Amanda's team. Here it comes. Listen up, everyone. It's kitchen sound number one.
It's a mouse.
That was it. Short and sweet. And no, it wasn't a mouse, so you can hear it again if you like. Kitchen sound number one. What do you reckon that was?
What was that?
Is it us? Yeah?
Oh, it's one of those. Somebody doing a noise. It's sort of like trying to do a...
Squeezing or...
A cork out of a bottle. Just...
Amanda, what do you reckon?
More metallic to you.
Yeah, it sounded metallic.
Mm. So, what are you going to go for? So what else do you cook with, if not a microwave opening?
An oven.
Oven doors, correct. Yeah, well done. Yeah. There you go, have an orange.
Whoa.
And a bit of hush now, please. A bit of hush. And stand by for sound number two.
This happens as well.
Keep listening. Scratching around and then...
Lighting the gas. And then lighting the gas.
You're going to go with that one?
Matchbox.
Yeah. Sounds like somebody throwing up.
That's not somebody's eating your bowel.
Dalmatian raiding the meat department of the fridge.
It could be that, but in fact, I'm going to take your first answer because it's right. It's a gas hob being lit with a match. So, well done. You're going to have a couple of bananas for that.
Whoa.
Listen up. Sounds. The last one from Amanda's team. Sound number three.
Taking the top off a teapot and putting hot water into it and putting the top back on.
And pouring
You've earned yourself, mate, one big melon.
Oh, yeah.
Give a round of applause. Three sounds now for Nutter's team. Here's sound number one.
Washing something under the tap.
It sounds like, and I stood beside it. Yeah, there was something, definitely a lot of something escaping.
Steam.
Steam, so what do you
pressure
see?
Cooker.
You want to go with that?
Yeah, I'll go with that.
A pressure cooker's correct there. Go and have a couple of lemons. Yeah. And have an orange. Here's sound number two.
Food processor.
Is that your final answer?
Yep.
Are we happy with that, food processor?
Yeah.
That's the correct answer. Well done, Dawn. And here comes sound number three.
Rolling pin. Rolling pin.
Oh, that's beautiful, that.
Yeah. No, I'm just dancing. A rolling pin. Rolling out what?
Rolling over pastry.
What kind of pastry?
Shortcrust.
Is uncanny and correct. Rolling out shortcrust pastry. Right, if we look at the scores, well, on my left we have 1-2 big melons, couple of oranges, a lime, a lemon and 2 bananas, but they've stretched them out to try and make them look more.
Yeah, well,
not fooling me.
The banana's having a bit of a ruck with the lime.
You know, it's all off, is it?
Pardon?
It's Grant Mitchell and Beppe going at
well,
it again.
Yeah, is
it?
Just as bad as us.
Oh! And we're out of time. As I look to my right, I can see 2, 4, 6, 8.
Yes.
Who do we appreciate? Lemons, 2 bananas, a lime, an orange and a melon. Today's winners, ladies and gentlemen, Nutter, Liza Goddard and Mandy Smith. Which means today's losers are going to face my forfeit roulette. Now, we all like jelly beans, don't we?
Yes.
Yeah.
I mean, yes.
You're not working anymore. You keep your hands on the desk. Now, 2 of these are nice fruity flavoured jelly beans, but one of these is a brand new experimental American jelly bean. It's the jalapeno red hot pepper. They're in a shot glass. We would like them down in one.
Oh, my God.
Will it be Melvin Hayes getting the jalapeno red hot pepper? Will it possibly be the team captain who led her team to shame and disgrace? Or could it be our guest who we wouldn't want to offend, John? Okay, let's count them in from 3. 3, 2... One. Down in one, Bob. Spit them out if you don't like him, Amanda. Oh! Give them a round of applause. They are good losers. By the way, if anyone would like them, I'll leave them up here for after the show. Our thanks to, though, today's losers. John Altman, Amanda Grant, Melvin Hayes. Give them a round of applause. And today's most excellent winners, Liza Goddard, Andy Nutter, Mandy Smith. From me, Paul Ross, you have been watching A Slice of the Action. Make sure you catch us the next time we're back on your box. Till then, bye for now.